Hi, it's Zach here, and in today's video, I would like to introduce to you our line of soldering products we carry here at Cable Wholesale. For this demonstration, you'll need a soldering iron. We're gonna use the one right here. We also carry two other versions, including a battery operated and a pencil type. Your helping hands tool, male and or female ends, depending on your needs. The cable you're gonna repair, we have a 15 footer right here, a Phillips head screwdriver, and of course a tester for after the soldering process to make sure that everything was done correctly. So first, what is soldering? Soldering is the process in which two or more wires are joined together by melting and putting in a filler metal. So why might you need to solder? In this tutorial, we will be repairing an XLR cable that's been roughed up over the years that could still have potentially many more years of good use. So now, let's get to soldering. First, you want to cut off the damaged end of the cable, and from the cut cable, you'll have to prep the cable for soldering. First, you'll make a jacket cut, then cut the outside jacket. It'll take a little bit to pull it off, and once you do, it'll look something like this. You'll want to take this braid and form a brand new conductor. And so it'll give you three conductors. The braid, which will be the new ground, you also have hot and cold. Simply remove this paper and these little strings here, give them a little cut with some scissors, and you'll be good to go. Eventually you want it to look something like this. Each of the two hot and cold are going to be, the jacket's going to be pulled back, and you have three conductors here. You want to trim these down just a little bit so they'll fit easily inside your XLR end, and then we can start the soldering process. First, make sure you put the XLR connector, either female or male, through the wire before you start soldering. This step is very important as it could lead you to start the process all over again. Next, use your helping hand tool to hold the wire in place. Take your soldering tool and melt some of the solder onto each wire, also known as tinning, to help ease the connection of the wires. Now, pay attention to the three-pin connection on the XLR head. One is going to be your ground wire. Two and three will be your hot and cold wires. Make sure you are soldering the wires to the correct tip on the connector, otherwise your XLR cable will not work. Solder the 10 wires to the connector. Again, pay attention to the numbering on the end of the XLR head to make sure you are soldering the wires properly on each side so that they match. Melt the solder of each wire to make a connection to the connector. Once you've soldered the three connections, use pliers to squeeze the back end of the connector to the cable to ensure that you have a secure connection. This helps relieve stress of the solder from being the only thing bonding the connector to the wires. Attach the XLR head to the connector and screw the screw back on the XLR head. Now, use a cable tester to test your cable to confirm if you have pinned it out correctly. If the lights are solid red and in a pattern like this, it means you have succeeded. We have other solder connections and products we carry here at Cable Wholesale, so be sure to check out our entire line of products. If you have any questions, you can reach us by phone, Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. Eastern to 5 p.m. Pacific, or email us or leave a comment below. We hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you can get notified of our latest videos. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time here at Cable Wholesale.